Welcome aboard, guys. It's Yannick for the first episode of Underwater Photography. You actually start scuba diving and you find the underwater world amazing. Every creature is fascinating you and you find all the corals so amazing. That's why you are on my channel for look which compact camera you need to buy. But of course, since we are underwater, we need some specific camera and some housing. Or else, they will take a bath. If you want to start to take underwater picture, for me, you need to think about a compact camera, like the G7X Mark II for me, is smaller and a lot cheaper than the DSLR or mirrorless. I'm just a passionate of diving. It's also my work. And I take picture every time in the water. For example, I win the first prize last year in the compact wide angle camera. You can see there. So do not hesitate to ask me some question in the comment. I will answer you fast as possible. And also, you can check my Facebook and Instagram account for more picture and content. But before I present you the three camera I choose for you, you need to ask yourself three questions also. First one, do you really want making picture underwater or video? Second, do you have at least 700 euros to buy some materials? Of course, you need compact and housing for your camera. I will present you different housing for the three camera in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe just there. So don't miss the next video about the housing. And finally, third and last question, do you dive enough for spend a lot of money in a new camera? If you make only 10 dives per year, maybe an action cam is enough. But again, it's up to you. If you have 3 yes, you are sure you want to spend a lot of money and make a new passion, let's continue. Up!
I have prepared a little table for you with everything you need to know. I selected the Olympus TG6, the Canon G7X Mark III, and the Sony Ericx 100 Mark VII. And we will look for 6 things. First one, the megapixel, after the resolution for video, the zoom, the burst mode, the other specification, and of course the price. As you can see, the Olympus have only 12 million. The Canon and the Sony have 20 million. But depend for what you want to do. If you don't need to edit your picture, it's just for souvenir, 12 million is enough. But after, if you want to edit and make your picture look like professional, I recommend you to go on 20 million. For the video resolution, it's very easy. They are equal. But maybe a little advantage to the Canon with no crop in video. For the zoom, the Olympus and the Canon have almost the same. 24 to 100 millimeter is totally enough for do wide angle or macro. Now the new Sony have a 200 millimeter. I don't know what to say about this one. I never tried it and I never saw someone to use it. But I think for do super macro is a big advantage. After, the burst shot is how many pictures can be continuously taken without releasing the button. And there, of course, we can see the Olympus can take 20, the Canon 30, and the Sony can go up to 90 pictures. I personally use the Canon, and 30 is totally enough for me. Now, going to 90 can be amazing if you get a big shark come in front of you, and you don't want to miss your best shot. The other and specific characteristic for each camera. We have the Olympus. Very good things is waterproof already. And we have a special mode for do super macro. The Canon can do slow motion up to 120. It means 4 times slower. And for the Sony, you can go to 6 times. That is totally amazing. And of course, the last thing, the price for the Olympus, only 290 euro. For the Canon, we are to 625, and the Sony to 1082 euro. In conclusion, we can say that each camera has its money worth. If you are looking for the entry level to start the photography, the Olympus is the perfect for you. If you are looking for the mid-range with enough megapixels to make editing, the Canon is for you. But if you want to try to be a professional with a compact, the Sony is a perfect weapon for you.
Thank you for watching, guys. If you like this kind of video, don't forget to put a like. Don't forget to subscribe for the next episode. And put in the comment what kind of camera you will buy or you have already. Bye-bye!